guys, Mitch here from Cinema Suite. Welcome to the second director tutorial. In this one, we're going to be taking a look at director groups inside of Cinema Director. Let's jump right into it. So there are four kinds of groups in Director. There's actor track groups, character track groups, director groups, and multi-actor groups. In this video, we're just going to be taking a look at director groups. And we have our director bot example scene, beginner example scene open right here. As you can see, we have a director group right at the top over here. And inside of groups, you put tracks. And inside of director groups in particular, you can put audio tracks, global tracks, and shot tracks. So this up here is a shot track. If you expand the track, it will tell you what camera each shot is associated with. And to change that, you just go to set camera. Let's make a new one just for demonstrative purposes. We'll go to the plus, and we will go to add shot track, and that's pretty much it. To add a new item, you just hit the plus again, and you get a shot just like that, and you can stretch it out. Maybe we'll turn snapping off, and yeah, put it wherever you want. Right click, set camera, and associate a camera with it, so that way the shot knows what camera to cut to. Yeah, that's kind of it for shot tracks. You just arrange the shots how you like them. And if we go into game mode here, you can see it cuts. And we can change the cuts just like that. Precise, it's handy, it works. The next kind of track is called an audio track. We have one right here that we named dialogue track. And if you expand it, you actually see the waveform of the audio. So that's pretty handy. To add some new audio, you just hit the plus button and pick an audio clip. How about we throw some goat at the beginning and it will drop it at your current play head position. So yeah, we got a new goat in there. So we can trim the audio clip, maybe get rid of the goat partway through, and we can actually drag it and skip it over other clips to rearrange them. But that's not the only way to add audio to your Cinema Director cutscene. If we come over to the plus here in the director group, there's a third kind of track. There's global tracks. And in global tracks, we have a little library of functions that we thought would be useful. The first of which, there's a whole variety of them, but the first of which is called play clip at point. And it lets you very simply just pick an audio clip, like maybe cube fall heavy. And you can just put a single point instead of a clip. And you're playing, and it'll play that audio clip, just like that. Really simple. Next in global tracks, we have play, pause, stop your cutscene. Could come in handy. There's also some functions for debugging if you want to log some messages or whatever you developers do. There's also GUI texture fade texture, which is pretty neat. You can pick a texture like director splash, like we did at the beginning here, and it will fade on for the first quarter of the clip, stay on for half of it, and then fade off for the last quarter of the clip. You can even tint it if you want to, if for some reason you want, I don't know, red Cinema Director. Anyway, next we have game object enable and disable, which is very, very useful. Say we'll do disable game object. If you're just starting out with Unity, maybe you don't know what a game object is. Anything in the hierarchy here is a game object. Like DirectorBot, he's a game object. All the lights, all of the walls, all game objects. And game objects have this checkbox right here. All of them do. And disabling the game object is basically just flicking this checkbox. So now when DirectorBot is disabled, doesn't exist in the scene anymore, can't affect anything, and then re-enabled and he's back. So that's enable, disable game object. We also have time. Set time scale. This one's pretty cool. Come over here and tell it what we want to slow it down to. Let's say 10% of its original speed. Now say the cutscene is playing along and you hit that set time scale and bam, slows down to 10% of its speed just like that. And that's pretty cool in itself, but there's another slightly cooler version. It's called time scale curve and it's a similar thing, but it's in a clip instead and you set the shape you want the curve to be over here. Let's say we want to start at full speed and then kind of ramp down to like quarter speed or something like that. Let's do a really steep drop off. Yeah, something like that. So now when you're playing, it will ramp down, kind of like a 300 or the Matrix sort of effect. We also have transitions. There's fade to and from black, of course. If we do a fade to black, we actually do a fade from black at the beginning, but fade to black for the duration of the clip, it fades to black. And that's it. Pretty simple. There's also color transition if you want to do a custom color. Also pretty self-explanatory. Under utility, we have load level. In Unity, levels are referred to by a number. So if you want to load a level during your cutscene, we added the functionality for that. There's also the mass disabler, which is pretty similar to game object enable disable. Difference being, you can target as many game objects as you want. So say we want to turn off, let's do director bot again. And maybe a couple planes. Plane. Now for the duration of that mass disabler clip, the stuff that we told to turn off will turn off and then turn back on when that clip is done. So it turns off a bunch of game objects at once. And lastly, we have a thing called storyboard, which just, very simple. When the playhead crosses storyboard, it takes a screenshot and puts it in the specified folder over here. And that's pretty much it for that. If you want to export an image sequence instead of just a screenshot, there's actually a video we have that tells you how to do exactly that in Cinema Director, and I will link it in a card right now. But anyway guys, thanks for watching this tutorial, I hope you learned something. If you're just getting into Unity and you wanna maybe get your feet wet, I would really recommend Cinema Director as a tool to kinda get you started. Or if you're an established Unity user, get Cinema Director and it will make making cutscenes and other scripted events, any scripted event like this, a whole lot easier. Anyway guys, I'm Mitch from Cinema Suite, thanks for watching.